kicking in.
Cool.
There we are. Hi, everyone. Hope you're doing well. This is Chicho, and we're on March 31st, 2019, the last day of March. Tomorrow's April 1st. Fun. Welcome to another live stream, and we're going to spend time in the kitchen. Okay. And we're going to have breakfast. We're going to make gluten-free pancakes. And I got a whole bunch of ingredients and whatnot that we're going to use. And we're just going to chill. We're going to hang out and talk about whatever you guys want to talk about. Talk about life. Talk about music. Talk about economics, politics. Talk about food. Right? Movies, comic books. As usual, we'll give everyone, just a few minutes to roll in. And just to let you know, I'm starting to think about setting up regular times for certain things that we do. And one of the things that we're going to do, we're going to spend a lot of time in the kitchen. So I'm thinking about setting up a regular live stream for either every Saturday or Sunday. Here, where we can just have breakfast, make food, and chat. Okay. I'm gonna run in a couple places and make sure it's gonna work out, and make sure we can make almost every Saturday or Sunday, depending on when we set it up. If you have any opinions regarding on the day, if it should be Saturday or Sunday, please post comments in the videos. When they're uploaded to the BitChute or YouTube or wherever else we can upload it. And if you're in the chat, I'll mention this again and I'll do a little poll, just a random poll, just to see if there's any dates that people prefer. Okay. And we'll probably make the decision next 2 to 3 weeks. Aside from that, we got two cameras set up that are going to shoot the tops here. I'm messing around with the lighting a little bit. Should we keep it off? Should we keep it on? Top Fiverr, how you doing? How's the sound quality, by the way? I think I kicked up the gain a little bit. I might kick it up a little bit more, because people have been saying it's pretty quiet. So I want to make sure the sounds are coming through. It's difficult for the cooking live streams, because there's accidental loud noises, so I don't want the loud noises to be too loud. That's gonna freak people out, me included. Right? Hope you're doing well. RS Blunden, hey Chicho, have you seen the new Avengers coming out? Savage Avengers, Conan is one of them. Oh, I looked at that. I don't know how to take that, man. Looks awesome. For me, I really don't want Savage Sword of Conan to be kicking it with Captain America and Iron Man and stuff, okay? I consider Conan to be on the same level as Lobo, right? I love Lobo, I love Conan. So Lobo's from DC Universe, Conan, Marvel has the rights to it now, right? And as far as I'm concerned, DC has been bastardizing Lobo because they're farming him out to like Justice League and stuff, and I tried reading that and I can't appreciate it. To me, Lobo is a solo character, no team affiliation, go do your thing, right? That's the essence of Lobo, right? Like a rebel, like a barbarian, right? Like a warrior. I consider Conan to be on the same level from the Marvel Universe, from the Dark Horse Universe until a few months ago, right? So I don't know if I appreciate Conan. I don't know how they're going to treat it. If they're going to be kicking back and partying, living it up with Captain America and Iron Man and stuff like this. Because if you read a lot of Conan in the past, from my experience, what I remember a lot is a lot of the people that kick it with Conan when they're going on adventures or they're warriors or they're thieves or generals or whatever it might be, a lot of the secondary players in Conan comic books end up dying because it's brutal, right? And Conan is killing people and chopping people's heads off. And he's like, what do you call it? Captain Kirk in the original Star Trek. Every maiden he comes across, he likes having a good time, right? Lobo is the same. So I don't know how that's going to play out with the goody goody Disney inspired characters, right? Even though I love the Avengers, I love that universe. Quality is great for me. Lighting is fine. Okay, awesome. Awesome. We keep it the same. By the way, we're gonna make gluten-free pancakes today. Okay. And I know a fair bit of people that have gone gluten-free. And I'm not gluten-free. I love pancakes. I've been making pancakes for a long time, gluten pancakes for a long time. But because I know a lot of people that have gone gluten-free, I've been trying to perfect my recipe for gluten-free pancakes. And this is, I don't know, the umpteenth iteration of gluten-free pancakes, right? And I've got it down pretty good. The video is a little choppy for me. It could be because I'm running my laptop. I'm signed up for the release in May. I'll let you know if it ends up being any good. Okay, let me know for sure. For sure, let me know. Okay, I'm curious because I am jumping on series that people are recommending. The Conan I haven't jumped on yet, but I've jumped on the Venom and Immortal Hulk series and stuff. So let me know. I'm open. I'm open, right? I'm not closed off to it. As for the video being a little choppy, it might be because of the computer, the laptop I'm using. I got two computers going in, two monitors going in, right? And we've got a third one here, right? So let me show you the angles we're going to use. We're going to do a doink and doink. This is the stovetop that we're going to use to make pancakes. Okay, here's where we're going to do a lot of prep work. Okay, and it's going to be gluten-free, and this is almost perfect recipe. Okay, it's coming off fantastic. The last four times I've made it, it's coming off fantastic. I'm gonna provide the recipe, okay, in the description of this video if you're watching it after the live stream. And in the live stream, we might fine-tune it a little bit. Okay, Rajan, Raj, on, Rondo, thanks, Raj. How you doing? So the recipe will be in the description of this video. Okay, Chicho, my man, hope all is well. It's just a ride. It's just a ride. And we're gonna try to make it as fun as possible, right? Enjoy the ride, enjoy the ride. And those people who are interfering in our ride because they've forgotten that it's just a ride, we're gonna have to make sure we correct the situations, right? What ingredients do gluten-free pancakes substitute the gluten pancakes? I'm gonna give you the recipe and I'm gonna read it off to you what I'm gonna be using. Okay. We might fine-tune a little bit from what I've written down, but here's the main ingredients. Here's basically, let me read off the recipe to you. Okay. I got 1.5 cups of general gluten-free flour. Okay. And I'll read you what the ingredients of the one. I've tried a few different ones. They're all the same, right? They all work the same. So this one, you can decide for yourself which gluten-free flour you want. Okay. Morning, morning, Chicho. You've got to the stream. Awesome. Glad to be here. Awesome. Nice to have you, Zari. Fantastic. I'm glad you figured out the Twitch notifications. Here's what the general good evening, Taco. Oh, Taco's talking dessert. So here's what it contains. The what's it called? I don't want to give the brand name because it's just gluten-free all-purpose flour. That's what I'm using, and this is the flour that it has in it. Okay, it's got rice flour, buckwheat flour, corn starch, potato starch, tapioca starch, and zeaxanthin gum. I guess that's the either preservative or some kind of bonding thing. I don't know what that is, right? That's the chemical in there. Okay. So we're gonna use 1.5 cups of that. We're gonna use 1.5 cups of just tapioca flour. Okay, and this is just tapioca flour that I bought, I put it into the jar. Okay. We're gonna use 1.5 cups of brown rice flour. Okay, and again, it came in a bag that I'm putting into a jar. Okay. We're gonna use about a third or half a teaspoon of baking soda. Okay. We're gonna use 1.5 cups of yogurt, and I'm using 3.5% yogurt, grass-fed yogurt. Okay. There's gonna be 3 to 4 cups of water. We're gonna see what the flour feels like, and 1 egg, and the egg is optional. Okay. That's what goes into this gluten-free recipe. So what I'm gonna do right now is, this is the stovetop we're gonna use. Okay, so I'm gonna turn this on to, I'm putting it on 2 right now, really low. I cook this stuff on low heat. Okay, so I'm cooking it on, and my stove tops are pretty, they burn hot. Okay, so 2 for me might be like a 4. I've used other stove, the elements. Like a 2 on this is was equivalent to like a 4 or 5 on some of the other ones. Do you use a flame stove or electric? It's an electric stove. I don't have the flame stove. Oh, let me move up the chat. Here. Put it up top. That way it appears better. And let me change the dimensions on this so we don't lose the chat going up. Forgot to adjust the chat on this thing. Let's kick down the height on it to 700. Okay, that should contain it. And where is the alert box? Oops. Alert box in a good place. Okay, cool. So the chat's all set up. Hey Chicho, happy to be here. I'm eating some breakfast with you. Awesome, Spider. Awesome. Nicholas, how you doing? Awesome. I live the cooking stream. I love the cooking streams. Hey Chicho, hey chat. So let's do this. So I got this thing put on too. And what I'm going to do, I'm using coconut oil right now. Okay. I'm going to take this much. Here, let's see if you can see it. This much. And just let it sit there. Okay. And let it, it's just going to melt slowly. And what we're going to do is, gonna start adding the flours and mixing things up here, okay? So, to keep things legit, I'm using legit measuring cups, right? And I usually, I usually just use, I've started using these measuring cups. I never did until we started doing the live stream because I wanted exact measurements, okay? But I was, for years, forever, really, I was always just using a cup from, you know, just a drinking cup, something like this. I would call a cup. Okay, so you can do your adjustments. You don't need like a serious measuring cup. Okay, and we got a tea going as well. So let me put this in. Yeah, let me show it to you. So this is the all-purpose flour, right? You can see what it looks like. So that's 1. Ooh, that's a little too much. A little too much. So that's about 1/2. A little bit too much here. We'll do this. That's about 1/2, okay. And this recipe will feed 4 people. Like really, well, depending on how much you love your pancakes, right? You might want to eat a lot more than what we do. Fact, coconut oil is one of oils that aren't very fatty, is a neutral oil and is almost has no taste. Cool, nice fun fact. Here's a tapioca flour. So I'm going to use 1.5 cups of tapioca flour. tapioca flour. And what it does, I don't know if you guys have ever eaten, what do you call it? Those Korean dessert sweet bean stuff, cakes that they make, and Chinese have of them as well. And they're sort of squishy and chewy, and just the texture is fantastic with them, right? So it gives that type of texture to the pancakes. Okay. And on the outside, when we cook them up, they get sort of crispy, right? So the oil is melting here. So I'm going to spread it out a little bit, okay? And you do want, you're going to end up oil. Is it NATO? I don't know. The coconut oil? Is this politics question, Taco? I'm against NATO. But is there a. And this is the brown rice flour. So I'm going to use 1.5 cups of brown rice flour. And rice flour is good. But rice flour, one thing is, it's very crumbly. So the tapioca works good with it to sort of hold it together. And we're going to use one egg as the sort of a binding to keep it together. So that's 1.5 cups of brown rice flour. Let's move these guys here. Keep our space. Free up some space anyway. Okay. And I'm going to use baking soda. Just a third of a teaspoon. This is how much I'm using. Maybe half a teaspoon, but yeah, about a half a teaspoon. Okay, spread that out. X, how are you doing? Welcome to another live stream. I wake up early, and I made sure I didn't eat because I wanted to eat the pancakes, right? So I'm hungry. Hungry, hungry. NATO is a type of bean. Oh wow, that becomes sticky and starchy after. Oh, is it? I didn't know that. NATO. NATO. I don't know that. That thing. Will you add fruit as well? Yeah, let me show you the fruits we got. Actually, let me get this going because I like the yogurt water to sort of absorb the dough a little bit. Okay, so let me get this going and then I'm going to show you the fruits. And for sure, we have fruits. Game at home, mom. How are you doing? How did the muffins turn out last time? So I do this just to mix the flour so it's consistent, right? Before adding the yogurt and the water. Okay. So that's that. This out. We're going to put yogurt in here, add water. Okay, so we're going to put 1.5 cups of yogurt, and this is my yogurt. Dab it out. And I use 3.5% yogurt, the fat content. Let's bring out a clean one. So I'm just going to pour it in here. So that's 5 tablespoons, I guess. And 1, 2, 1.5. So that's 1.5 cups of yogurt. And we're gonna add 3 cups of water. So let's bring this here. And then we're gonna mix it all up and we're gonna add the egg. So one. And again, the egg is optional. A little tough. I tried to replace all-purpose flour with sprouted wheat, and it made them a little tough. Today I, by the way, I'm just kicking this down a little bit. Today I made pancakes and only replaced the third of a flour portion with the sprouted wheat, and they were awesome. Awesome, awesome. Yeah, it's really weird when you change things up. The flour, they act so different. Like, it's taken me a long time to get this gluten-free flour for pancakes done well, okay, where we're like delicious. Okay, where's my so here's the egg, right? And I'm just gonna mix it all up. And then we're gonna add this to the flour and mix it slowly, right? I like making a thick fruit spread and spreading it on my pancake. Yeah, we use jam for that. A lot of jam. Might do today. I got sour cream. I wanna eat the pancake, so I'm sort of on a sour cream binge a little bit right now. And got feta cheese. I got feta cheese in here that we're gonna use. And honey. I'm craving honey. Okay. I might add more water as soon as we mix the flour. Okay. Mix this with the flour. So let's bring this out. I'm gonna mix this as we add the liquid. Okay. So let's. Check this out. I got this sitting on low right now, and a little bit of the flour fell in there with the liquid, and it did a sizzle. So this element burns really, really hot. Sleepy Ways, how you doing? I might add a little bit more water. You'll see the texture that I'm going for. And I usually go, I'm shooting for the texture. Right? That's sort of the way I work with, you gotta follow a recipe when baking as well. Baking is more chemistry, right? But when you bake something, when you make something, enough times, you know what the dough is supposed to feel like, so you can adjust things a little bit to get the dough to the right consistency, right? Not bad. So this is good consistency. Good. I don't know what you call it. Can't even pronounce it. I'm moving today. I'm so overwhelmed. Oh no. Oh, are you serious, Sleepy? Moving is just. I've moved way too much in the last 15 years or so. It's crazy. One thing I've started to do, probably not for this moving tip, Sleepy, but what I've decided to do is eat the costs recently in the last few moves and take a month to move. So if you're moving to a new place, if you're renting and stuff like this, just rent it 2 weeks earlier and just move things slowly to the new space. Okay. So that's good consistency. Okay. So let's put this guy here. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna use another bowl to transfer some of the dough, and we're gonna make different types of fruit dishes, fruit pancakes. Okay, so let me show you what we got. You never know just how much stuff you have until you have to move it all. Yeah, I like to use my hands when mixing so that I can feel the dough. Yeah, for pastries, for sure, you need to. For pancake, you can't. For pancake, no. Moving sucks. But when you get there, you get relief. You do, and it allows you to clean things up, purge, right? Chicho, have you ever tried a vegetarian, vegan diet? I've eaten. There's been periods where these blueberries we're gonna use, right? There's periods where I've gone not veggie for over 2 weeks, right? So I've always had meat in my diet. This is cherries we're gonna use. So blueberries, cherries. We got strawberries. Okay. And these strawberries were mixed with oh, the blueberries, cherries, and strawberries were from the freezer. They're frozen. The strawberries I had already mixed with sugar a little bit and put them in bags because I was gonna make jam out of them, right? So the strawberries had a little bit of sugar in them. We have apple, okay, pear, banana. I think X, it was you one time when we were making pancakes, you mentioned banana. I got some lemon. I wouldn't mind doing some lemon zest pancakes. Okay. I've never tried. It'd be interesting to try it. And cinnamon and chocolate chips. Okay, we'll see how much we get done. How many of these we end up making. I tried going without meat. Foggy headed, but bad. I don't know if that's a physical or mental. I don't know either. My body requires the meat. Okay, that's what I've learned. I don't think everybody in the world could go veggie. It's impossible, or vegan. And some people should only be vegan or veggie. The last time my family moved, it was 10 years ago, and I can still feel tired. I feel you, Taco. I don't want to move again. Yeah, banana is my favorite. Yeah, X, it was you. And then I remember I chopped up the banana and I mixed it in with the dough. And then I think you said, oh, you could have mushed it up as well. So we're going to mush it up and then mix it with the dough. Okay. So for our first pancake, how about blueberry? Let's do this. We'll bring this out. Bring this here. So I'm just going to take some of the dough from there, put it into this, and then we'll mix in blueberries and make a batch. That's even too much. Okay. That's going to be two pancakes worth. So I don't want two pancakes worth. I'm going to take some of it back. So I put about 1.5 spoonfuls of this big in here. Okay. We'll see if it's going to be, I think it's going to be more than one pancake. And I just want to basically make one of each pancake. Let's do a big spoon here. Let's make a big spoon. Actually, do we want a big spoon? Oh, we can just pour it in. So I'm just going to pour in blueberries in here, okay? Enough that I'm going to be satisfied with blueberries. A little bit more. And I've tried different types of blueberries, and the best blueberries are the ones that are the wild blueberries that are small. Small blueberries make the best pancakes. These ones are on the bigger side. So we'll mix it up. I'm just going to use a spatula to pour it in here. Kick it up a little bit. Let's do this. Spread the oil. And I'm going to kick up the temperature to 1.5, a little bit less than 2. Cool down a little bit too much. Usually, I like it to sizzle a little bit more than this. Okay, so I'm gonna kick it up to 2. Just spread it out. And this is gonna cook nice and slow. And that's the way I like cooking the pancakes. Very nice and slow. But I'm gonna kick it up a little bit more. We're hungry. I've got a lot of pancakes to make. So I'm kicking it up to 3.
Okay.
And I have my spatula here that I'm going to use to flip things. Okay. And small blueberries, they don't give up as much juice. For some reason, it's just with the bigger blueberries, there's a little bit of, they cook up in there a little bit and they give out a lot more juice. The smaller blueberries came out different. It was they were very good. Very good. For the next one, let's make banana. So what I'm gonna do is take half a banana, squish it up and throw it in here. Okay. Easiest way to cut a banana in half. You can use your nails as well, but just cut that and then you could just go like this. All you need to do is give a little sliver in a banana and it will break. I really love making crepes. Yeah, crepes are flat pancakes without any baking powder, and you can fill them up like burritos and fill them up with Nutella tortilla. And crepes I find harder to make. You've got to be really on top of crepes. Crepes is really good. You can make a sort of crepe style of omelet. Take eggs and beat the eggs and add some yogurt water or milk or something and make it very liquidy. Pour it on top of a hot pan and it cooks really fast. And you need oil, you need to flip it and stuff like this. And they're good. You can fill it up with stuff. Hello, Miss Olga. How are you doing? How's life? By the way, just in case, if you guys missed it at the beginning of the stream, one thing I'm thinking about doing is starting to, now that we've done live streaming for about a year, I've been on sort of Twitch for a year and a bit. Until we got the ball rolling on it was about a year. Actually, I'm gonna put the whole banana in here. So I've been moving times around and whatnot. So what's your popping? We're making, I don't know what that means, but we're making gluten-free pancakes. With fruit. Okay. Having a day of shopping. I'm thinking about setting up a regular schedule for these cooking streams and making them either on Sundays or Saturdays. Now, if you have a preference to when you would like for us to have regular cooking streams, okay, and we'll try to make them most of the time, let me know. I'm gonna decide in the next 2 to 3 weeks of now that this is sizzling. I'm gonna kick it down to two. Okay. So if you have a preference, let us know. So I put another 1.5 of dough. Crepes are easy if you had enough practice. You just need to follow the recipe and look for any browning at the ends, and you can test it by sliding a thin spatula. And if it doesn't stick, then it's perfect. Ah, that's exactly the same way I do with pancakes. If you notice, I just did this, right? I sort of do this. And that's right. You want to be able to move it up with pancakes, right? And you know what's getting done. And what I look for pancakes is in the middle, you get little bubble pockets, little holes that gas, I guess, is escaping, right? Or it's a hot spot where it's like curdling away or whatnot, right? So once it gets to that stage, I know it's a good time to flip it. And for the scheduled cooking streams, okay, once we set them up, so for example, we'd say, okay, every Sunday at 10 a.m., we're gonna do sort of a cooking live stream in the kitchen with Chicho, or we're gonna have a breakfast podcast with Chicho, something like this, right? So I'm gonna try to start setting up regular schedules. So sometimes we'll make pancakes, sometimes we might make crepes, taco. I wouldn't mind doing a cooking stream where we're trying our hands and making crepes, right? Sometimes eggs, bacon, sometimes just yogurt, cereal, whatever we feel like, right? Whatever we feel like. Next, banana. Should we do banana and chocolate for the next one, or just banana? Chicho, do you play video games? I haven't played for a while, but I am a gamer. I've played a fair bit of video games in my life. Teach me how to make a quiche. Oh, quiche. I can make quiche versions, but we can look up a recipe and go legit quiche. I can grab my mom's recipe. My mom makes amazing quiche. Oh my God. It takes a little bit of work, prep work and stuff, but it's not that hard. I've seen her do it, right? For sure we could do. For sure we could do. As for video games, for sure. Spider. At some point, I'm gonna get back into video games. I've been aching to just go off on a game, and I haven't had the opportunity. Bacon pancakes. Making bacon pancakes. Take some bacon and put it in the pancakes. Bacon pancakes, that's what it's gonna make. Gonna make bacon pancakes. Okay, we could do. Why not? Here, I'm gonna flip it right now. Just so you see what it looks like on this side, right? It's getting nice and brown a little bit. So once it gets like this, where I can flip it easy, I do flip it. And let it cook on the other side a little bit, okay? Yes. Just make sure the bacon is crispy. Yeah, crispy bacon. And I make my bacon in the oven. I don't fry it on the pan. What kind of video games? Oh man. The game, role-playing game that I finish from beginning to end without any cheats. Cheats. is Vice City. That's one of the games I played. I played a lot of online games. There was a Star Wars online game, sort of capture the flag and free for all, killing everybody and whatnot. It came out in 1999, 2000. Jedi Knights, I can't remember what it is. I still have it here. 2000, 2001, 2000, 2002, 2000. I can't remember when it was, right? Late 90s, early 2000s. I used to play that a fair bit. And I went as the handle Chicho back then. That's like 20 years ago. Warcraft, I used to play a lot, right? That's in the 90s. Played a lot of Warcraft. And just regular, you know, NES, Sonic, Herzog's Zugui, one of the best, what's it considered? It's considered to be RPG. Is it RPG? It's considered to be the original, one of the first. It's not a role-playing game. It's where you have a base and you're fighting against someone with a base that they're building stuff. It's like a Warcraft game. It's considered to be the first one, and I still have them. It was on the Sega Genesis system. Computer games, my first games were computer games. Long time. Long time. I'll support whatever you stream, but a video game stream would be so cool. Yeah, I will be doing video game streams for sure. I just need to start setting up regular schedules, which we're gonna try to do with this cooking live stream, okay? And then slowly we'll get into video games. Imagine how bacon pancakes would taste with maple syrup. They taste amazing. And or with honey. I love honey. Vice City is classic. Vice City is amazing. Really. Ever play Ultima Online? No, I've never played Ultima Online. Nostalgic. I played Vice City. I just played it every night, basically. And took me 3 months to finish it. And I wanted to do it without cheats, which was fantastic. This is what happens with the blueberry pancakes. They start, what do you call them? Getting sticky to the pan. The small blueberry pancakes don't as much because they're surrounded with the dough a lot more. Online iPhone was so good too. Stepping stones for RPGs nowadays. I hear the creator of Ultima Online came out with a new game recently. Yeah, I heard that too. I've had friends, family that have played Ultima, that I've watched. Blueberries pop out of this too, right? When they're bigger. We're gonna eat half the pancakes that we make, and we're gonna save the other half. Then we can eat a lot of variety of pancakes. I can't wait for classic World of Warcraft to come back this summer. I didn't know. I'm not keeping up to the news of it coming back. Like the old school Warcraft with the map view of you making your bases and building and expanding. They're bringing it back. I know there's still a lot of people playing it, but no, it's just big business these days. Wow, so it looks like they are bringing it back. I missed the early 2000s. I'm kind of young. Vanilla. Oh, vanilla too. Yeah, the early days of gaming were phenomenal, right? I'm just adding a little bit of coconut butter to this, or coconut oil to this. And bigger fruit is messier because there's water in them. So when you put more oil, it sizzles a lot more. That nostalgia feeling is the best feeling in the world. And one of the things, the earlier games as well weren't as commercialized as they are now. In the old school games, when you walked around the world, you didn't see advertisements of companies too much. You saw graffiti from artists and stuff. I don't know what it's like now, but I think there's a lot more advertisement. Thanks, Free Mart. It should taste delicious. It's a little thick. Usually I make them a little bit thinner, but we'll keep it thick like this for now. I also miss the early 2000s, the golden age of cartoons. I was born in 2000. Oh wow, you were born in 2000. Nice. My brother-in-law was a Y2K baby. I was born in 93. Simple Ricks. Hello, hello. Yes. Pancakes were concentrated in one area. Oh, not pancakes, the blueberries were concentrated in one area. Let me bring out another plate here. I'm putting that guy here. So we're gonna put it here, cut it in half, transfer. Everyone, Y2K, we're gonna die. Maybe. Scary thought though. Nice blueberries. And blueberries, I try to get organic. Because the non-organic gets sprayed a lot. Too much, really. Let's transfer some honey over. Let's transfer some honey over into the container. Thanks. Love it, buddy. It's a nice pan. We treat our pans well. I'm just transferring some honey over that way. It's easily accessible to eat the pancakes, right? Let's bring out the sour cream. Let's put that here too. Let's bring out my feta. Let's put that here too. Leave that one. Feta, right? Delicious. Let's put that here too. Some movements. Let's see what this pancake is like. Nice. Get the blueberries out of there. And as soon as we put the pancake over here, we're just gonna oil up the pan and put in a banana pancake. Blueberries have a compound in them that makes it harder for cancer to eat up blood vessels. They're called anthocyanins. Cool. Uniting all homes. Reaching out to home. You're free. Vaccine is free. But let's put this guy here. Okay. Let's put this guy here. Okay. Let's put a little bit of this, and I'm gonna kick the temperature down on this a little bit. Okay. Let's throw in banana pancake. Where's our spatula? And we're gonna hear a sizzle on this guy. pancake. Okay, let's put this guy here. We'll let this one cook. I'm gonna cut this guy in half. Let's see. Nice. Put a lot of blueberries in there. Nice. Yeah, I'm gonna transfer this guy over here. Okay, oh, we lost the blueberry. Grab it. Let's have a taste of this. Yeah, this is really, I've tried the gluten-free stuff in different places, because in my part of the world, there's a lot of gluten-freeness going on. These are really good. Really, these are really good. For sure, half could be for you, why not? At some point, hopefully, technology will be able to transfer it over, right? Just let me hold it up to here too. Take a look. Whoa, drip, drip. Let's put a little sour cream. Nice. I've been prepping for like 3 hours, 3.5 hours for this. So looking forward to eating this. Ah, thank you for the follow, Supreme. Delicious. And with the sour cream, so good. And the honey, so good. Thank you for the follows, gang. And the subs, it's really been subs, I might be missing them. I'm immersed in pancake eating. I'm gonna be putting some feta cheese on the side too. Pancakes and feta and honey, blueberry. Man, you can't mess with this. Fantastic. Let's gobble up the blueberries. Thank you for the follow, Godlike. And the tapioca pudding, tapioca flour, really gives it a fantastic crispiness on the outside. Fantastic. Oh, the banana's sticking a little bit. I'm gonna turn this down a little. I'm gonna scrape this off. Thing to burn. Oh, the banana is becoming caramelized. Interesting. Squishing the banana. We'll see what it turns out like. It's really sticking to the pan though. Okay, we let it cook. We put it on though, we let it cook. It needs to harden. Stuff going on. Not sure what they are. Uh-oh, we got trolls in. Let's check it out. What was that command? What was that command that Casey posted? Oh, Valiance. Thank you for being in the house. Gotta write that down, that command that Casey had written down, where you have to be sub for a limited amount of time. Check it out. Oh. Nice. Valiant, you're taking care of it. Let's check it out. Here, let me turn off the chat so it doesn't appear on the screen. Having to deal with weak churls while you're eating pancakes? Craziness, craziness. Follows 10 minutes. Thank you. Did it work? Unrecognized. Oh. What was it? Followers, 10 minutes. Followers, 10 minutes. Usage, followers, duration. Apple followers only mode. Only users who have followed for duration may chat. Ah, nice, worked. Awesome. Let's turn on the chat on the screen again. Da-da-da-da-da-da. We're back. Hopefully we didn't burn the pancakes. We're getting the bubbles on this, so that's good. The banana is really squishy. Maybe half a banana was good enough, babe. This side. Definitely need the thin spatula, eh? That looks great. Still very squishy. Now we let it cook. Oh, I'm out of pancakes. More pancakes. That's, wow. I pop out. Chaos, chaos. Well, gotta allow. Hey, what happened? That person? How come they're able to do that? Hey. Should we do followers 30 minutes? Someone already did it. Nice. The trolls are weak today. Oh my god. It's like 2-year-olds. No, not 2-year-olds. You have to at least have hair under your armpits to be this bad of a troll, just at the beginning stages. Like a little kids in the corner playing with themselves. Don't know what else to do. neckbeards, yeah. That's funny. Oh, we gotta make more pancakes. Oh, we gotta add more fruit. So which one should we make now? Chocolate. It's time for chocolate. Let me put this guy. I'm gonna put this guy in the oven, so stay centered. Next one we're gonna make chocolate. Spider, leave Chicho alone, he's making pancakes for us. Oh, is the chat on? I think so. Oh yeah, the chat's still there. Good. Let's put this guy here. And this is where we're keeping our utensils that we're gonna use. And let's make chocolates. That's So again, just the dough, and I'm gonna use, let's see, that's good, that's a little bit more, that's good, that's plenty of chocolates. Mix it all up. So this guy's ready to go as soon as the banana is done, right? Hey, how come these guys are bypassing the ban? Weird. Very weird. Boop. Okay, we'll turn off the chat on the screen. Okay. Interesting. It's not working. I'll do my best trying to make pancakes and do the band. I guess Sunday morning these kids don't have school, right? So maybe we should make our regular schedules. No, we don't want to make it during a weekday breakfast. Sunday breakfast is good. Mass band rolls. Only so many hands. It is. I guess they need. It's sad to see, really, because there's so much that can be learned and done in the world. Basically, a lot of trolls, the way it works is, they're just tools of the establishment. That's the way I look at most trolls. They're either a byproduct or a tool of the establishment, right? Oh, really? Can we not allow ASCII? How do we ban ASCII? ASCII too, byproduct of Detroit. I don't know. Is there a command to ban ASCII? Amon will have to do it. Amon will have to do it. Okay, we'll try to do it on the next go. I'll ask the mods next time. No, ask you. That's great. That'll get rid of the. I mean, it's ASCII 1980s images. ASCII that would come up of people, and you'd be done dial up waiting for 5 minutes for this ASCII to pop up. Funny, funny. Oh, look at this. Easy grab. Doink. You can open Nightbot dashboard and add ASCII. Oh, okay. We'll do for the next stream. I'll try to send myself a reminder. Let's see how our banana is doing. Banana's looking good. Let's kick up this temperature on that a little bit. I'm putting it back up to 2. Let's put it back on here. We've got the chocolate ready as well. Quitin letters like the block they use to draw. I don't know. Must be possible, Taco. Dude, I like your name. Oh, it's Gaga Kata. Model now. Fun. Okay, good. Valiant, you there? We don't get this type of troll action too much when we do math. I guess the trolls really don't like math. Maybe they're intimidated. Maybe they're scared. Maybe the reason they're trolls is because they don't know mathematics. They don't realize that there's so many more amazing things to do than to troll, You can rule the world if you want with mathematics. Enjoy every aspect of the world that you want with mathematics. Spend a little time learning mathematics. I can type in comments to block ASCII for you if you want. For sure. Titan Soul, Supreme Admin Bot. Supreme Admin Bot, I've never seen you before. Very educational too. Too much power for them to handle. Maybe. I think one thing that happens with mathematics is it is extremely powerful, if we're talking about that right now. It is extremely powerful. But once you acquire certain power and certain mindset, certain perspective, if you're going to be evil, you're not going to be troll evil. You're going to be pure evil. You're going to do things that are huge, right? So either way, it at least empowers you, right? Chisho, do you see the leaked suit of Mysterio from the... No, I haven't seen it. Or maybe I have. We brothers can vouch for Herman. Imad's Twitch. I'm sorry, man. I can't make anyone a super mod or a mod if I don't know them. Gotta get approval from the other mods, right? There's too much power. Can't do. Let's cut this in half. Is this cooked on the inside? Very squishy pancake banana with the tapioca. It's just pure deliciousness. Let's check it out. I think we'll have to let it cook a little bit more. No worries. Just get a mod on to add the comment. Okay, I will, Super Admin. Thank you very much for offering, by the way. I just have to run it past the other mods. I don't... I've only been on Twitch for a year, right? So... I was given a warning before from the mods that, you know, you have to be careful and whatnot. So I'm playing it safe. Speaking of comics, have you ever read Art Spiegel's I've read parts of it. Really good narrative on the Holocaust, and just read it for the third time. For the third time, wow. No, I've read parts of it. I haven't read it from beginning to end. It was really good, but it's just like Joe Sacco's Palestine. I've read parts of Joe Sacco's Palestine, but I can't read the whole thing. It's so depressing. It's so heavy, right? So I like heavy books. I like the, you know, sad books, depressing books and stuff. But sometimes certain things has just become too much. So I haven't read it from front to cover. If you can type it in now, you can. It's symbol. I can't do it right now, brother. I got pancakes going, pancakes lining up to do, and some pancake eating to do, right? And I am trying to stay up with the chat. Who did what? Christ Wisp. And yes, I definitely agree. There's only been a handful of books that I had to stop due to how heavy the contents were. Man's Searches for Meaning is one. Oh, I don't know that one. Man's Searches for Meaning. Who wrote that one, Jinx? Yeah, there are certain books that are just too much. And one of the reasons I think it just happens is if you've already read it multiple times, if you understood what's taking place already, then it becomes, you can only handle the same heavy, depressing story that you've read before multiple times. Right. This banana pancake is gonna be crazy. We'll let the banana pancake cool down a little bit while we make our next pancake. Let's make cherry. Should we make cherry? If there was racism or a false accusation of racism, either will be banned. Excellent valiance. Yeah, no pointing fingers, right? That's like, as far as I'm concerned, in our political system and stuff like this, there are people who accuse other people of crimes, and then you find out that they lied. If you find out they lied, you try to destroy someone else's life, then everything that was going to happen to that other person that you were trying to destroy their lives should happen to you. Next one. Should we do cherry? Let's do cherry. I'm gonna throw some cherries in there. Take a look. Here's the cherries. Okay. Oh wow, this is gonna be crazy cherry. A little more. One more. No, that's enough. That's enough cherry. Let's mix this up. So we got our next pancake ready to go. This is going to be very much like the blueberry, of course. Definitely agree. The amount of false rape claims, I'm going to allow that for sure. It didn't like the word they used, right? But it's a legit, in the modern age, definitely high. Oops. Didn't really want to add it as a permitted term. Cherries are so good for you too, for same reason. Yeah, berries in general are amazing. I didn't say anything to anyone. Spider, it might be me saying I was snitching, so I blocked them. Saying, yeah, Spider, looks like we got the trolls coming in, and they're trying to create a little bit of havoc and stuff. They might be the same people that lost out during Russiagate or something. They're like this, trying to create controversy and stuff. Ignore them, Spider. That's okay. It's like those little, some people that have issues that pop up. Apologies for the vulgarity. Oh, no worries, Jinx. It's a legit word. If you cannot message me a screenshot of it, then you will be banned, Chris. Nice. Nice. I will send it to you ASAP. Thank you for being fair and just. Yeah, and Spider is legit Valiance, as far as I know, as far as I'm concerned. I hope it's the same Spider. There are many cases reported of false rape accusations by women and men go to jail until proven wrong, or the victim confesses to the false accusations, and when the truth is out, the female victims get a slap on the wrist, and as well as men. It should go both ways, right? If you try to destroy someone's life, then you have to be called for it. X banana pancake, phenomenal. Very good. Very good. Super delicious. Wow. Thanks for popping by, Taco. Thank you for being here. Apologies about the little bit of chaos in the beginning. I'll have to spend some time on Nightbot and setting some stuff up. That way, we give more power to people who've been here and less power to the trolls. Nothing better. And nice heavy discussions. And by the way, one of these once a week, once every 2 weeks. I'm looking at setting up a legit schedule now. Okay. So if you guys have a preference for us to do live streams either on Saturdays or Sundays, let us know. Well, that's a first. Me being falsely accused of being racist. Man, there's Spider, there's people out there who haven't had a good life, who've I guess it was, what was it, in a Batman comic that Alfred was talking to Batman. He told him, like, it might have been in Joker, the Joker, where Alfred just tells Batman, there's some people just want to see the world burn, right? Sometimes because they've been heavily abused. And they haven't got the mental health care they've needed or the support that they've needed. Some people are just wired incorrectly. Some people, it's their choice. They can't do anything else in life, or they haven't realized what they can do in life or what their purpose is, if there is a purpose and stuff like this. So they lash out. I've come across some of them. It is at 80. Is it 80 years now? 39? 1939, right? Superman was 1939. 1938, Superman. Batman was 1939, I believe. Happy anniversary, Batman. Yeah, they're all crazy. And society makes them crazy. Our current economic system makes them crazy. Our current political system makes them crazy, right? It's not necessarily, it is their fault who they are, like how they've decided to interact with the world. But there are other circumstances that have brought them to where they are. Now, no excuse for them, right? If you do something horrendous, there is no excuse for it. You have to pay the price, right? You can't justify doing things that are bad just because bad things have happened to you, right? That doesn't work that way. Life doesn't work that way. Oh, look at this one. Very nice. This is the chocolate one. Very nice. When everyone is turned against everyone else, the people turning people against other people capitalize on the situation too, 100%. That's why a lot of trolls, a lot of people who are lashing out and stuff like this, they're just tools. They're just an instrument for capital, power, for them to accumulate more power, and they're discarded. They're not really. They haven't figured out what it means to be a human being yet. No problem. Best of luck with the adoption. Thank you. Wow, that's a sexy pancake. That's a sexy pancake. Nice. These banana pancakes were fantastic. Very good. hot pancake ready. The chocolate pancakes staying together really nicely because it doesn't have any extra liquid from the fruits kicking in, right? And tea's always got to be there. Let me do a prep for our next pancake. Let's do. How about we do apple? I like apple pancakes. Sorry for trolls, Chicho. You definitely don't deserve. It's okay. I didn't. Spider, it's like a fly, right? If a fly comes in and buzzes around, we can't get really angry at them. It's unfortunate that they're. It's like, what do you call it? I think everyone, personally, my take is everyone deserves a chance. But in a classroom, in a group of people, if they're trying to learn, and I've had this happen to me, where they're trying to learn, and there's one or two disruptive people in class that are interfering in everyone else's learning process, right? Now, in general, I'm really good at handling that situation, but even me, sometimes I've lost my cool in a group of people where maybe it's because I related to this kid and I thought I was speaking to them. There's one situation that I really recall that came out with me where I had a group of people, I was teaching them the sort of, what do you call it? We were doing reviews as a group. At the time, I had a few students. So I was teaching this one kid, and the parent came up to me and said, "Hey, listen, is it okay if it, this, their son's twin or brother, I don't know if it was twin, it was an identical twin, it was a brother, if they could come and join in the sessions as well?" And I said, "Listen, in general, I don't put people together in a group that I don't know because I don't know how the dynamics of them." But they were like, "Oh, please, they're not doing well." I go, "Okay, sure." So they brought him in. And the reason the kid was doing poorly was because he was disruptive. He was angry. He was frustrated. He just couldn't relate to anything that was being taught to him and didn't really appreciate the way grown-ups were treating him. One of the reasons is because a lot of grown-ups weren't treating him properly. Another reason is because he was an idiot, right? In not a malice type of way. He didn't get it. He was a teenager. He was like 13, 14, 15 years old, right? When you're 14, 15, when you're that age, you think you understand, but you don't, right? So this kid came into the group and stuff like this, and I had a whole bunch of people sitting around and answering questions and stuff. And he started doing things. He started doing things. And he was in my house, right? My space. And he was being so disruptive. I told him, "Listen, you need to step outside." And he refused to step outside, right? And as soon as he did that, I sort of lost my cool. And unfortunately, this session didn't go well. It was like a 3-hour session for everybody else. And it really angered me that the parents knew who I was and they tried to, last minute, try to introduce their kid to me so I could make them understand. But this kid was at a level that a one-time meeting was not going to make him understand. Some people reach a point where they need to be broken before they can be put together again, right? And unfortunately, I wasn't gonna break this kid in front of everyone, in front of his peers, to try to put him back together in a 3-hour session. It wasn't gonna work. So I personally learned a lesson through that, which was basically in group settings like this, sometimes you encounter people who maybe have had it rough in life or haven't figured out that they have it very good in life, right? Those people usually end up down a dark path, and half of them probably don't end up making it out. The half that do make it out into adulthood and into life, trying to figure out who they are, half of that ends up being very good. Half of that ends up being the type that wants to see the world burn or themselves burn. They're very destructive. Now, That's the way I look at some of the trolls. Good thing they only stop by for a couple of minutes and realize they have no effect. Yeah, they do have a partial effect. They, for people that deal with those types of tools in everyday life, it's unfortunate that they have to deal with those types of tools in this type of environment, right? It's unnecessary, but we have to consider where they're coming from. What you said about breaking and rebuilding is very interesting. Never thought about it like that. Yeah, I've had to do that with some people, both as a teacher, and I'm gentle when I break. You can't totally destroy them. You can't put them back together, and if you can't put them back together, you own that, right? As an instructor. So I'm very careful with that. In my day-to-day actions outside of my work environment, when I'm dealing with kids, sometimes you have no choice. You have to break them right off the bat, right? And it's not up to you to put them back together. You just have to show them that they needed to be broken. And there are different ways of breaking people. Entheogens is one of them, one of the most powerful ways to do it. But that requires a tremendous amount of time, energy, and effort. Chocolate one next. This. Nice. Let's put the apple on the side. Let's bring this guy back. Let's break this guy in half. Oh, look at that. Look at this. Look at that. That's nice and chocolatey, eh? Nice. Let's put that guy there. Let's put this guy here. Let's put a little bit of coconut oil in the pan. Spread that out. And then we'll transfer over our cherries. While we're doing that, let's set up our apple. So we're gonna pour the apple in here. That's enough. So we have the apple ready to go as soon as the cherry one is done. You're so patient, Chicho. I grew up in a very negative and aggressive family and situation. I have troubles with my anger, and when trolls go crazy, I tend to get hot at it. It's key as a teacher like yourself to learn self-control and patience. I try to, and I guess it just comes with experience and age. Spider, I've gone through my life where if people poke me, poke really hard back, right? So I had to realize, and to me, it just basically came to realizing that I didn't want to be in that situation, right? Because if I hurt someone, emotionally, physically, whatever it might be, I didn't like it. And if they hurt me, I liked it even less. So I stopped. I figured out how to, a way to stop, de-escalate situations, right? It doesn't always work. And I step away, right? Sometimes you have to write things off. It's a write-off, right? It's just the way it is, right? But it comes with age, I think. It comes with patience and practice. And breaking yourself and rebuilding yourself in large part. That crunch, opening split it. This banking. I've been eating chocolate. What's going on? I forgot about this. Yum. Let's try this. Let's not put anything. Let's not put honey on it yet. Let's taste it by itself. Oh, wow. Very chocolatey. Let's add a little sour cream on this. Very good. This and banana mixed together would be fantastic. I made it crazy chocolatey. Let's try it with feta cheese. Jik is, I've always tried to be diplomatic myself, but most of the people I grew up with tend to go first, fist over mouth, and it kind of forced me to approach things peacefully and patiently. Dude, fantastic. I wish I had learned that from the beginning. Really. It's difficult, it's a hard thing because in our world, in our society, it's reactionary on every level. Like even from healthcare, people don't think about maintaining their health. They don't think about preventative measures. What they try to do is deal with symptoms when they show up. So it's reactionary. Our education system is reactionary. Our economic system is reactionary. Our political system is reactionary. It's crazy. Thanks, Chicho, for your kindness and wisdom. I will use it to better myself and my ideals. This is why I love your content. Well, all my pleasure, Spider. It's just, man, one of the reasons I share, one of the reasons I'm doing this is because I think life will be better for everyone if everyone is able to filter out the noise of the control mechanisms and the economics and politics that's being shoved down our throats to control us and to get us angry, to get us to join a certain group, to attack another group, right? If we're all able to filter that noise out, those control mechanisms out, they will not have no power over us politically, economically, socially, in any way at all. Every now and then, we might come across people that are brainwashed on that level, but that'll be seldom. The outrage engine, exactly the engine, right? The outrage engine. Right? And right now, unfortunately, there's a lot of people that have that outrage engine cranked up, right? So, like, I have people freak out on me, right? Like, seriously. It's profitable. It's economics, right? It's economics. Look at this sherry. Oh yeah.
Nice. Very good. Very good. Look at this chocolate. This delicious.
Nice flip, huh? That's one thing. One reason I find using tapioca flour in these pancakes is absolutely fantastic. Because it crystallizes, like makes it, gives it a nice crust when you're cooking the pancakes, so it stays solid, right? This is, I've made some cookies with the tapioca flour. It took me a while to figure out how to play with tapioca flour, what it's, how it cooks, right? But this is because of the tapioca flour. If we had the rice flour in there and no tapioca flour, it would fall apart, crumbly. Okay. Sizzles or ASMR in and of themselves. Nice. Maybe we'll make just a straightforward with the lapel mic ASMR video for this. Whenever I try to flip mine, I always mess it up. Yeah. It might be a spider, you're flipping too early. I used to do that as well. You can't flip too early. Yeah, I've used spat flour as well, but not too much. I played around with it a couple of times, but I couldn't mix it in well with the other stuff that I was using. It has high protein, and I want it to go well, but so far all my cookings with it have gone bad. Yeah, same with mine. Like, I tried. I bought, I forget what the containers are, like 1 pound bags or something, just to play with it. And it didn't work well. I wasn't able to, I think it needs to be mixed in with a different type of flour for it to be used well. I just haven't figured out what that is. If I ever do, I'll share for sure. Starkey, how you doing? Hit your troll. I finally, how much did I miss? You missed so far blueberry pancake, banana pancake, chocolate chip pancake. This is the last bit of it that I'm eating right now over here. So chocolate chip pancake. We have cherry pancake going. Apple pancake in the pipeline. And some other things that are waiting to be made. Well, I'm off to take a shower. Enjoy the pancakes, Chicho, and I hope everyone here has a great day. I may pop back in if we're still going at a bit. Okay, awesome. Enjoy your cleanup. Hope you have a fantastic day. Okay. Let's check this out. How is this guy doing? Oh, this guy needs to be cooked still. No, that's not ready yet. I'm going to add a little bit more oil to this. A little bit on this side. And a little bit on that side. Chocolate pancake was strong. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna take these other half pancakes, and there's someone in the other room that might enjoy them, so I'm gonna set them up a plate.
Blueberry as well, right?
Be right back. Getting coffee. Ooh, coffee, nice. That's a lot of pancakes. That's a lot of pancakes.
Love the pancakes, man. Love the pancakes. Absolutely love the pancakes. Let's do this. We put some feta on the side.
Yeah. Let's put some feta here. Better here. Let's put some honey in there. We got honey, and what I'm going to do is when the cherry pancake is done, I'm going to cut that half and put it there, and we got this. Should we put some sour cream too? Let's put some sour cream, a little bit, here as well. They like sour cream. We got to share. Needs to cook a little bit more on this side. The apple pancake might be our last pancake.
We have strawberry here.
We had lemon zest, eh? Should we try lemon zest? Well, let's put the apple in there. Maybe we'll do one more after the apple as well. Lemon zest would be delicious. I've never tried lemon zest. Break this guy. This smells really good. Chicho, I think you would love Red Dead Redemption 2. I've seen it played. I have one student that's played it. I had family members that played it. It's a lot of fun. I'm playing it right now. Nice. Yeah, it looks beautiful. I played a little bit of Red Dead Redemption, the first one that came out. And what do you call it? Rockstar played a lot of their games. I had friends in the gaming community that were developers in the late 1990s, early 2000s. For about 8 years, I was kicking it with a lot of developers and stuff like this. So I got exposed to a fair bit of favorite of games, the gaming world. We'd spend some time just playing games and Grand Theft Auto, just kick around Grand Theft Auto, Drive. There's a fair bit of games that are absolutely fantastic. Okay, let's put that guy in. Let me go do a delivery. I'll be right back, okay? Love doing deliveries. What's up, Chicho? Girl Joke, how are you doing? How's life? Haven't seen you in a while. Ooh. Yeah, there was a lot of small companies back in the early to sort of mid 1990s. There was a lot of developers in Vancouver. I knew a lot of people from H2O that worked on H2O. New Tetris for Nintendo 64. A lot of other games, like the Hulk game, I knew the people who designed it, who came up with it, programmed it and stuff on the front and back end, right? So it was cool. It was cool being around that. Flipping pancakes. That's a cool bit. Nice heart. This one's apple. This one's thick. You gotta thin it out a little bit. Thin this guy. Cooks well. And usually when I'm cooking pancakes, I have one pan here going, one pan here. So I make two at a time. As you can tell, because it goes slow, right? Oh, apple pancakes are amazing, Spider. Yeah, apple pancakes taste fantastic. I could have added a little bit of cinnamon too. Should we add a little bit of cinnamon up top? No. We'll add it when we're eating it. We gotta try the cherry. April is going to be a good month for movies and TV. Barry and Game of Thrones come back, cool. Happy just started again. Grant Morrison's Happy. If you haven't watched the Happy TV series, if you can handle hardcore just violence and just chaos and trippy and funny and it's mature content is very, very good. Come back and HBO and Avengers and Shazam come out in theaters. Oh, awesome. Cinnamon nutmeg and apple spice. Ooh, I haven't tried that. Nutmeg and apple spice. All the stuff I like. Nice. We'll make it taste like apple pie. Oh, really? Cinnamon, nutmeg, and apple spice. Okay. Oh my God. Yes, my wife and I love Barry. And Game of Thrones is gonna be amazing. Avengers is gonna be incredible. I'm seeing Shazam on the fourth. Nice. I heard Shazam's supposed to be fantastic. I don't know what Barry is. Barry's amazing show, Chicho. If you haven't watched, no, I've never watched Barry. What is Barry? Really, agree. Barry. Is it related to comic book stuff? It's the first time I'm hearing about it. Wow, cherry is really good. Bill Hader. Oh, from Saturday Night Live. Barry is with Bill Hader from Saturday Night Live. He plays a hitman, former Marine, who tried to become an actor. Oh, I have never even heard about this. It's really good, eh? I'll put it on my radar. I just finished, it's based on his experiences back when he was going to acting school. Really? What? No, I never heard about this. On the controls of the stove. So we gotta fix it up. Funny, violent, sad. Three things I love. It's more drama based, but there are funny moments, huge range of emotion. Has Henry, oh, Henry Winkler, Winkler in it. Wow. Yeah, it's shocking how well he is in it. The man can act. I'm used to his comedy role. Wow. Okay. There's a lot of praise for this. Thanks for putting on my radar. Like, there's some amazing shows out there. Like, really. The stuff, like, I don't think, I guess Barry's not comic book based, but for the comic book community, just to share with you, a lot of us that have been collecting comics and reading comic books could have never imagined some of the content being created in terms of movies and TV shows that would have ever transferred over from comic books to movies or TV shows, right? Like Doom Patrol is one of them. No one, until it was announced, ever thought Grant Morrison's Doom Patrol would become a TV series. Like, what? Was nominated for Emmy. Hader won a Primetime Emmy for Best Actor in a Series, and Winkler won for Best Supporting. Wow.
Okay.
Look into it. Look into it for sure. I just finished Deadly Class, by the way. Last night, no, night before, I think. I don't know if you guys have watched Deadly Class. But they filmed it in Vancouver. Okay. I have yet to see Doom Patrol, but I hear great things. It's pretty cool. Doom Patrol is pretty good. Like, really, I was apprehensive at first. I didn't think they were gonna be able to do a good job. They did a great job. Okay. Deadly Class, they've done a good job. But just to give you a little tidbit, the comic store that you see in, oh, this guy's Steve. Should have added more. The fruits that are, the fruits that are heavy, like the banana and the apple, they're sticking to the bottom of it. So I'm gonna add a little bit of coconut oil. This might be messy. We'll see. That's a sticky pancake. Yeah. Regarding, hey Tango Poco, how you doing? Deadly Class, that I just finished the series a couple of days ago, and it's a good series, very good series, based on the Image comic book, a Deadly Class by the same name, right? But in the series, you see them with working in a comic book store. That was the comic book store I would go to in Vancouver. That was my comic book store I would go to when I was in Vancouver. I'd always go there. Every week I was there. So that was my comic book shop. One of the two that I would go to, right? I had a pull box somewhere else and I would go to this one. And I stopped the pull box at someone else. I would just go exclusive to this one. So the comic book store you see there is the comic book store I used to go to in Vancouver. Fantastic comic book store. A couple of people that worked there that managed it that were phenomenal. It's no longer around. They shut down. So the odds are for Deadly Class in the next season, when they show comic book store, unless they've already filmed it, but I doubt it, the odds are it's not going to be the same comic book store that they originally filmed in. It's going to be a different comic book store. And it was very sad to see it go, that comic book store. And there was a lot of politics involved and stuff. Very unfortunate. Wow, this apple's made it very sticky. This has got one apple in it. Well, three quarters of an apple in it, right? Had to approach it from a side where it wasn't sticky. Let's eat the cherry. Cherry pancake. way the filming goes in that comic book store, what the studios were doing, they would book the comic book store for 3 days, right? I guess the first day they would set everything up, and the second day they would do the shoot, and the third day they would continue to do the shoot and take it down. But one thing they would do is, because comic books arrive on Wednesdays, and the studios would only shoot Monday to Friday, if they needed to book it for 3 days, that means they always took up Wednesday. So twice I'd gone to the comic book store where I didn't know they were going to be shooting Deadly Class. I would go there and the store's closed, they got studio lights everywhere, all the trucks are outside, and I'm like, man, I'm here to pick up my comics. And they're like, oh, comic book store's closed, and the people that are working there, they weren't there either, right? They would open up the door, so we couldn't get our comics. And what would happen is, the comic book store did a few of these, and they were taking hits because they weren't able to sell the comics right off the bat on Wednesdays when they were coming in. So people would go get their comics in other stores and stuff. I would wait, but some people wouldn't. Okay. The behind the scenes stuff regarding filming Deadly Class. They would get paid well, the store, but there was some stuff going on. Very good with sour cream. Tapioca is amazing. Tapioca flour is fantastic. Really? Addictive. Very addictive. Tapioca comes from cassava plant. Really? Was that discussed before? Like, I didn't know. What is a cassava plant? Oh, Deadly Class. Mm-hmm. They just finished 10 episodes, I believe. But Benedict Wong is in the show, and I love him as Wong in the MCU movies. Cool. This is definitely my last pancake. I am full. But we gotta try the apple. No, we're gonna let that cook a little bit more. Cassava plant. I've heard of the graphic novel, but I didn't know they made it into a show. Yeah. Rick Remender is the writer for the comic books. Right, and it got picked up and it's out as a TV series. They just finished the first season. I believe they just finished the first season. Yeah, they finished the first season. It left it at a weird cliffhanger. So I didn't like it the way it ended, the like where they left it off. I wish they resolved a little bit more, but they're coming back with a second season. It had some seriously funny parts. It's very violent. Very violent. Good show. Very good show. Pancake belly. So regular live stream schedule where we have breakfast and talk about whatever. I think that would be fun. That might be our first regular live stream schedule set up every week. think it's doable. I think it's doable on the weekends. Doom Patrol is amazing. 9 out of 10 show so far. Yeah, agreed. Doom Patrol, 100%. As far as the original source material goes, how they adapted it into the TV show, I'd give it a 10 out of 10. I never in my wildest dreams did I think that Grant Morrison's Doom Patrol would turn into a TV series. Okay. Wait, what are you gonna do this every Sunday? Wait, comment. In the next 2 to 3 weeks, Tango, I'm gonna decide. I'm gonna pick either Saturday or Sunday, and we're gonna try to do a live stream every week. Our first committed, real time schedule to do, right? Because people have been asking me, when are you gonna do the next stream? When are you gonna do the next stream? And I always say, I post them on Twitter, I announce them here, but it's too much for people, right? So, to check every time. So I think some people told me that setting up a regular schedule would be a good idea. So we're gonna try, okay? I'll announce it in a couple of weeks. I'm gonna think about it, make sure it's gonna work out well, and then we do. Tango's laughing. It was a serious discussion I was having with some people. Look at this apple pancake. Look at this goodness. That looks great. Nice. Let's bring this over. Okay. I'm turning this guy off. This is our last pancake, right? Let's cut this guy in half. This is gonna be like squishy. Nice. That looks great. We'll eat the smaller one. This looks serious. Like, that's how many pancakes we made, and we have still this much, right? Dough left. And this will make, like, really, this is like 1, 2, 3, 4, at least 4 more pancakes, right? 4 or 5 more pancakes with that, if you include fruits as well, right? So that's how much pancakes we got off this recipe. We've made 4 over there, 5. So probably 10 pancakes with fruits. That pancakes looks like an hour to make. That's 4 more hours of pancake making. We made, I guess, 1 pancake every half an hour. Let's check this out. The apple in this is like totally juicy. Like, look at this. That's gonna be hot on the inside. Let's make it a smaller bite. Very squishy. Delicious. Delicious. I hope you guys had a good breakfast this morning. For me, it was well worth the wait. Well worth the wait. I'm gonna put a little cinnamon on this. Needs more sour cream. For sure. I'll use that much for now. With cheese, with feta cheese is fantastic as well. Let's put some cinnamon on here. Just a little bit. Just on this part of it. And with the dough, feta cheese, yeah. And with the dough of this, what we've made, you can easily just put it in the fridge and use it tomorrow. No big deal, right? Or the next day. You could use this flour, this dough, for like 3 or 4 days, right? It's not gonna go bad. So once you make the dough, you can just have pancakes for a few days in a row, right? If you know, you don't want to make 10 pancakes right off the bat. If you're just one person, you know, you don't need that many pancakes to eat. Like two of these things are plenty. We ended up having two and a half. This is our, if you put it together, it's two and a half pancakes, right? I'm lactose intolerant, so no cheese for me. So no sour cream either, right, Spider? Very good. Love feta though. Feta is amazing. Look, I'm not even putting any honey on this. The apple was pretty sweet. So you would put fish. So you would put fish on the pancake. What? Hopefully not with cinnamon applesauce. Or maybe it would taste good, I don't know. Thank you for the cheers, James. Eating pancakes and getting cheers. Life is pretty sweet. Life is pretty sweet. Now we turn it off, but it's still hot, right? So I'm just getting the flip so it doesn't burn. So full right now. I think I'm gonna save this for later. The rest of this apple pancake. Just put it on the side and eat it later. I'm super full right now. I hope you guys enjoyed, man. Gang. And I'll definitely post the recipe. Here, let me read it off to you. 1.5 cups of all-purpose flour, 1.5 cups of tapioca flour, 1.5 cups of brown rice flour, 1.5 cups of yogurt, and I'm using 3.5% yogurt, and I've used 2% as well. 3 cups of water, 1 egg, and about a third or half a teaspoon of baking soda, right? So I put all the flour together with the baking soda, mix the flour and the baking soda together. So it's like the dried stuff. So you're mixing the dried stuff together. And then I took the yogurt and 3 cups of water and the 1 egg into one bowl, mix the yogurt, water, egg together, and then put it all together, mix it all up. And once you mix it all up, this is what you get, right? And then with that, I'm adding fruit. And you could have it by itself too, right? That's fine as well. I love the stream. I'll be making them tomorrow morning. Awesome. I'm gonna try the apple pancakes. The apple pancake is very squishy. So maybe not put almost a full apple, 3/4. Actually, no, it's pretty good like this. It's a nice and apple-y, as long as you got good apples, right? Flavorful apples. With cinnamon it was good. With the sour cream it was good. And what was the other stuff? Nutmeg and apple spice, and what was the other one? Cinnamon, nutmeg, and apple spice. That's supposed to make it taste like apple pie. Chicho, see you next Sunday morning. Not sure if it's going to start next Sunday, Tango. It might be 2 weeks or 3 weeks from now, okay? I got a allspice, that's right. Thanks, Game at Home Mom. So probably in about 2 to 3 weeks, we're going to start a regular schedule. I want to make a video and make an announcement on YouTube. Hopefully we won't get banned off YouTube for telling people to go to Twitch every Sunday or Saturday. We'll see. Honey Crisp are the best. Thank you. You as well. Awesome. Awesome. So gang, thanks for being here. Apologies about the trolls. We had some ugly trolls show up today at the beginning. Next time when trolls show up, if I see a lot of comments and a lot of images and stuff being posted right off the bat, I'll turn off the chat on the screen that appears here, or somewhere else if we're shooting a different type of video. So we won't get that in the load up videos, right? It's just, you know, the way our political economic system is set up. Some people have, unfortunately, some serious issues they need to deal with. And we own that as a society, right? Have a great day, everyone. Looking forward to it. Awesome, awesome, awesome. Thanks for being here again. And I'll see you guys in the next stream and video. Okay. Bye for now.